Good morning, family. Good morning. Today is Wednesday, July 10th. I hope that everybody is up and they have all the energy in the world. Maybe not, depending on when you wake up or depending on when you see this. But today I will be bringing you your Wake Up With The Word. I will be speaking from Daniel. Speaking on the topic of Daniel and the Lion's Den. So yeah, I will be speaking on that. So I will let the music play a bit. This song, I'm not sure if you know, is Trusting God by Elevation Worship. Yeah, I love this song. Praise and worship team sang it at church at HCM. It was a few weeks ago, or maybe last week. I love this song. But yeah, just speaking on the song. But yeah, we can let the song rock out for a bit. And we can let just people in the room so they can get in. And then after a few minutes, I can go ahead and start praying and then we can get started. So, all right. I'll cut this down, and we can get started. So I'll just pray us in, and then yeah, we can get started. So dear Lord, I thank you for waking us up, Lord, and allowing us to see another day, Lord. Thank you for waking me up, Lord, allowing me to see another day, another chance to serve you, Lord, another chance to love you, to be more like you, Lord. To show your light through me. Lord, I thank you for the things that we take for granted. I thank you for those things. I thank you for the things that we take for granted, that we have, that we just, sometimes we don't know how we have them, but it's just, you allow them. You allow the blessings. You allow them to happen for us, Lord. And so I'm just thankful for that. Lord, I just pray, Lord, as I bring this week up with the word, Lord, that I pray that I am clear and I'm concise with the things that I'm saying, Lord, and that it is understood and that it is heard well. I pray, Lord, that whoever needs to hear this word, I pray that they are open to receiving it, they're open to understanding and digesting and letting it just sit with them, so that they can take what they need to take, Lord. So Lord, I just pray and I just ask all these things in Jesus' name I pray, amen. So we can go to Daniel chapter 6. And I want to focus on verses 4 and 5. So I will just go ahead and I will start reading. If you would like to read along, you can. I'm reading out of the NIV. But if not, I can just go ahead and read. So I'll just, in verse 4, it says, "Then the other administrators and high officers began searching for some fault in the way Daniel was handling government affairs, but they couldn't find anything to criticize or condemn. He was faithful, always responsible, and completely trustworthy. So they concluded, our only chance of finding grounds for accusing Daniel will be in connection with the rules of his religion." All right. So when we think of Daniel, we think of a person that is trustworthy, honest, faithful, and never wavering. Like this man was about God. Like He was about God. Like, that was it. Like, he didn't come off of that platform at all for any person or anything. All of the different accusations of people trying to get rid of Daniel, trying to accuse him of things, just trying to knock him off his feet. Like, Daniel was, as my brother Austin says, Daniel, he was 10 toes down. Like, he was not moving from God. And so at the point in Daniel chapter 6, we are met with King Darius, the Mede. So we have moved from King Nebuchadnezzar to King Belshazzar, and we are now with King Darius. And so at the beginning of chapter 6, King Darius, he has decided to split the kingdom up into 120 different provinces. And so the king, he chose Daniel to be over the high officers and to pretty much, I guess you could say, not I guess, but because it clearly says it in the Bible, but it says to protect his interest, right? Because at this point, Daniel is one of the high ranking, like probably the highest ranking officer in the king's service. And so because of that, he was put in a position because of his ability to be able to lead where he was. But then within the king's administration, there were men that I guess you could say they were jealous. They didn't like the fact that Daniel was positioned the way that he was. And so they were looking for a way to get rid of Daniel. So the verse that we read in the beginning in verse 4, it says the other administrators and high officers, they began searching for a way to get rid of Daniel, right? And so the only thing that they could pinpoint, right, or try to put a finger on was to use his religion against him. And so the king, they convinced the king to make a law that stated that if you pray to your God, I'm paraphrasing. Well, let me stop. I'm not going to paraphrase. Let me read the verse so that it's coming from the manual. So it says, so in verse 7, it says, we are all in agreement. We, administrators, officials, high officers, advisors, and governors, that the king should make a law that will be strictly enforced. Give orders that for the next 30 days, any person who prays to anyone, divine or human, except to you, your majesty, will be thrown into the den of lions. And so King Darius, he makes this law and he puts it into place and so that it cannot be changed. And so it then says in verse 10, it says, but when Daniel learned that the law had been signed, he went home and knelt down as usual in his upstairs room. Not wavering. This man, a law was put in place. He was like, nah, fam. He was like, I'm not switching up for nobody. I'm not switching up for anybody. He was like, we as believers of Christ, we should always be 10 toes down. And it sounds so easy to do, and it's not hard to do. We have to make it a point to be 10 toes down with God. Like, if somebody is putting a boulder in front of us, stopping us from reaching God, we have to make the decision to put in every single bit of effort to move that boulder out the way. And that's what Daniel did every single time. So it says in verse 10, but when Daniel learned that the law had been signed, he went home and knelt down as usual in his upstairs room. With his windows open toward Jerusalem, he prayed 3 times a day, just as he has always done, giving thanks to God. And so the officials, after the law had been signed, the officials, they went to his house and saw that Daniel was doing this, that he was praying 3 times a day. He was doing exactly what the law stated not to do. And so the officials, they were like, oh, they went back to King Darius. They're like, oh, Daniel's over here. He's doing what you said not to do. But King Darius, he did not want Daniel to go away. He did everything in his power to make sure that Daniel did not go away. But they took him away. And so it says in verse 14, hearing this, the king was deeply troubled, and he tried to think of a way to save Daniel. He wanted to save Daniel. Like, he liked Daniel. He spent the rest of the day looking for a way to get Daniel out of this predicament. And I'm reading out of verse 14. And so it says in 15, in the evening, the men went together to the king and said, "Your Majesty, you know that according to the law of Medes and the Persians, no law that the king signed can be changed." So, long story short, they put Daniel in the lion's den for doing exactly what they said not to do, for praying to his God. And he was doing it three times a day. So in 16, it says, so at last the king gave orders for Daniel to be arrested and thrown into the den of lions. The king said to him, "May your God, whom you serve so faithfully, rescue you." So they put a stone in front of it so he couldn't move. He couldn't go nowhere in this den with a bunch of lions. And let me tell y'all, I'm gonna put my Bible down for a hot second, right? You put us in a den of lions. Are we going to respond the way that Daniel responded? Are we going to move the way that Daniel moved? Even before they put him in the lion's den, are we in a place where our first thought, our first intention, our first reaction is to go to God? Regardless of what the situation is, regardless how hard it is, how easy it is, like, do we make it a point to consult with God, to talk to God, in spite of everything that is going on? Like, are we really that secure and knowing that God is going to take care of us, that God has our back? What we sing on Sunday morning about trusting in God, do we honestly do that? Are we spiritually in a place where we don't question our faith? Right? Because Daniel didn't question his faith. He knew what it was. He was like, God's got me. You know, I ain't got to worry about that. It's like, I'm going to go in this den. I'm going to go on the principle that I'm standing on. God's going to protect me from these lions. He's going to shut the mouths of these lions. Like, they're not going to touch me. Like, are we in a place where we love God that much? Like, I'm talking to myself. Like, am I in a place where everything is could be going wrong? My HVAC is not working. There's a piece under my car that's messed up, and I've got to spend a bunch of money. Or I'm just thinking of my situation personally. I'm just, even in these things, job is not going well. It's like, are we in a place where our faith doesn't get moved? We're on a straight line, and when things come up against us, our line doesn't shift. Our line stays completely straight every single time. I am striving to get to that place every single day. Am I perfect? Are we perfect? No. But I feel like we should be striving to get to a place where Daniel was, to be able to go into a lion's den, sit, and be cool, and not have to worry. So that it's just, it's something to think about. Like, this man, Daniel, he never wavered. His faith never wavered. He never doubted God about anything. Of all the things that happened to Daniel, never wavered. But I will tell you this, in the Bible, all of the examples, God was shown in all of those examples. King Nebuchadnezzar, he believed after the fact. Once he saw Daniel and how Daniel responded, he was like, oh, the God that you worship, it's a great God after the fact. So it's just, yeah. So in getting the word back, so they placed the stone over the mouth of the den so he couldn't get out. And so the next morning, King Darius, he hurried to the den to see whether Daniel was still alive. So in verse 19, it says, very early the next morning, the king got up and hurried out to the lion's den. When he got there, he called out in anguish, Daniel, servant of the living God, was your God whom you serve so faithfully able to rescue you from the lions? And Daniel was like, my man Daniel, he was in there chilling. He was, because he knew what it was. He answered. He was like, so in verse 21, he says, Daniel answered, long live the king. My God sent his angel to shut the lion's mouths so that they would not hurt me. For I have been found innocent in his sight, and I have not wronged you, your majesty. And so the king, because he loved Daniel. And it's like he loved him. He liked him. He was overjoyed at the fact that he was alive. So it says in verse 23 and just in continuing down, the king was overjoyed and ordered that Daniel be lifted from the den. And when he came out, what y'all think? Not a scratch, right? Not a scratch. Lions didn't touch him. Because he knew what it was. Like, I want my faith to be that strong. Like, I'm being honest. I'm being complete. Like there are situations. It's like my faith could be stronger in areas. And it's stories like this, and there are many other stories and examples of people and their faith not wavering. But it's stories like this. It makes you stop and think. Like the things that we say, the things that we preach. Are we honest in what we are saying? Do we truly believe that God can do more than able? Like he can do anything. He can do the impossible. Like do we honestly believe that? Because Daniel did. Like I'm trying to be like Daniel. And so in continuing the story, so he was overjoyed and he had the stone moved and there wasn't a scratch on Daniel. And so we find out in the next verse, the king gives orders to have the people that arrested Daniel to put them in the lion's den. And so they do that. And so they go into the lion's den. And what happens? What do we know that happens? They go into the den and they are eaten. The lions, they did what they did. And so it's, That should speak volumes to, one, to God. That should speak to his power, his ability, his being able to step in front of you and step in front of whatever obstacle is in front of you. In this instance, it was Daniel, and he was in a lion's den. But it could be anything. Like, it shows off God. But it also shows the amount of faith that Daniel had in God. And I'm trying to get there. And we should all be striving to get there. We should be striving to emulate Christ. Right? And so then in verse 25, King Darius, it says, then King Darius sent this message to the people of every race and nation and language throughout the world. it's happening again. So it's after the fact. People see what God can do. He can, they can see, this is crazy. This man was in a lion's den and he doesn't have a scratch on him. After the fact, King Darius is making this announcement to everybody in his nation. And what he says is, peace and prosperity to you. I decree that everyone throughout my kingdom should tremble with fear before the God of Daniel. After the fact. But before? No. Because he couldn't see it. But because he saw Daniel walk out of that lion's den, the power of God, the ability of God, it causes a man to completely shift and to make an announcement like that, to let everybody know, like, Daniel, through God, through Daniel, is showing God's light and what he's able to do, his ability. And I'm like I said, I'm striving, and we should all be striving to be of what Daniel was, to have the thought and have the intention to serve God the way that Daniel did, and to have your faith be 10 toes down, all the way in the ground, and not move even the slightest bit of, like, a vibration. You're not moving because you know what it is. And so, just reading the last verse in 26, I decree that everyone throughout my kingdom should tremble with fear before the God of Daniel, for he is the living God, and he will endure forever. His kingdom will never be destroyed, and his rule will never end. He rescues and saves his people. He performs miraculous signs and wonders in the heavens and on earth. He has rescued Daniel from the power of the lions. Excuse me. So Daniel prospered during the reign of Darius and the reign of Cyrus the Persian. And so I think To summarize this chapter, it's in everything that is thrown at us in life, because life is going to happen, right? Everything that is thrown at us, if we say we love God the way that we do, we should be 10 toes down. Like, no if, ands, or but. It's period. And that's it. And it just shows the amount of faith that this man had. Like, that's what it was. This man had faith on, like, 1,000. Right? So, The summary of this chapter is just, we gotta have faith. We gotta have the faith that we say that we do Sunday morning when we're singing. And it's cool to sing it on Sunday morning, but do we practice that? Do we practice that faith? So I pray that what was spoken today is heard, that is received. I know that in me going over this prior to doing this Wake Up With the Word, it's opening, it's eye opening, and it should be, and I hope that it's eye opening for you, and I hope that you can take it and you can just grow, right? That's our goal. Grow and strive to be as Christ-like as possible, and grow in our faith, and strive to have the faith that Daniel had going into a den of lions, because, as you know, lions can eat you. So
Yeah. So I pray that this Wake Up With The Word has resonated with you in some way, shape, or form. So I'm just going to go ahead and I'm just going to pray us out. And you guys have a great morning and a great rest of your week. And so, yeah, so I'll just go ahead and pray us out. So, dear Lord, I thank you for your lesson, Lord, in this Wake Up With The Word, speaking on Daniel and his faith and his trust in you. I pray, Lord, that as we come from this Wake Up With The Word, that we don't leave this, that we stay with this. And we look at our lives, we analyze our lives, and we check ourselves to see the things that we are saying, the things that we are preaching. Are we about that when it comes to Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday and Saturday? Like, are we about that when obstacles come, when people come, when finances come, when hurt comes, when loss comes? Like, do we have that faith in you, God? I pray that our faith grows stronger, super, super strong, where we are past 10 toes down, like our feet, they are locked with you and never going anywhere. I pray that we look to you first in everything that we do. I pray that I look to you first in everything that we do, everything that we ask for, all the struggles that we have, all the achievements that we have, but all of the things of life, when life happens, I pray that our first instinct, like Daniel, is to go to you, to find comfort, to find peace. So Lord, I just pray and I thank you. I thank you for your word. I thank you for this Wake Up With The Word. I thank you for your people. I pray that wherever we go, whoever we talk to, whoever we touch, because we are all in different areas and different parts of life, and we all interact with different people, I pray that your light is shown through each one of us, and that somebody can come to Christ through us, from your word, through you. So, Lord, I just pray and I thank you for today. I pray that the rest of the week goes well for everyone, and I pray that today goes well. And I just pray and ask all these things in Jesus' name. I pray, Amen. Have a good one.